With that, Lola feels her breath start to come in raggedy gasps. For the coldest, hardest fact of them all is that on a kibbutz, nothing is done alone. Everything is shared. Everything is communal. And the person who killed Fareed must be living amongst them. Lola lets the sun into her eyes for a minute, willing that dark spots block everything else out. But the questions flickering inescapably at the edges of her mind just start to warp and flare in the shadows. Why would anyone want to kill Fareed, let alone anyone on the kibbutz? And why would it happen, where and when it did, if it had nothing to do with her? The idea that this beloved spot of hers is truly universally communal, Lola knows the concept is as inconsistent as the geography itself, doesn't she? Lola's the one who works with an entire team that doesn't even live within the perimeter fence. The fact that her so-called love affair with Fareed cannot have been at all incidental is suddenly staring her in the face, even as she conjures the only image she never wants to forget. An impossibly handsome man, in the prime of his life, gazing at her as if she's all he ever wants to look at. He can't have been playing Lola for a fool. He just can't have been. Except the doubt persists, now growing as it morphs and shifts little sparks of light, popping and dancing in the dark, no matter how hard Lola stares into the sun. Waiting for me, hey? Instantly, Lola knows it is Andre who has caught up with her first, even though she can't see him properly. Hey yourself, she mumbles, rubbing her eyes, scattering little crescents across her vision.